Hello, people of the internet. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. It is now 10 past 9 in the evening on Monday, and we are back connected to the waves of the internet. And catching back up with the music that released today, continuing on with Ellis, who dropped a new MV for their song Thrill. Now, this is a group that, to my knowledge, I've never listened to. Just in my own free time, I may have come across like some of their older songs in passing, but for sure this is a group we haven't checked out here on the channel, and that is always very exciting when we get to expand our tastes here. Me especially, when they get to learn about new groups here on the channel along with you guys. So, what am I expecting out of this song? I have no idea. I don't approach new releases being spoiled to anything apart from concept photos and track lists, not even album samplers. So this is going to be entirely new for me, and that's tremendously exciting. So, video is on 4K. Unfortunately, we don't have subs on this video. But that's okay. Knowing me, I probably wouldn't pay attention to them anyways, because I get too distracted by the music. But I digress. I've got my earbuds in, and let's learn some new music. Here we go. Thrill. 3, 2, 1. That may have been about half a second already in.
Are you ready for this real? Here we are. Ramble.
Interesting juxtaposition of this like super slow, almost like sensual vocal line with this almost like dark brass line behind it. Heavy EDM beat now. Yeah, this song's got a lot going on. This was not the direction I thought this chorus was going to go. Pleasantly surprised by it. There's something that's retro rock about this that's not quite like 80s rock, but there's little elements of it that makes it sound very similar to it. Again, the juxtaposition of the quick vocals with the really gentle, like broad piano hits. So it has a little bit of the oppressive back in the chorus. And sticking with this kind of like retro theme for the bridge. Straight back into the final chorus.
Interesting.
Ooh, this one's made me use my musical brain a little bit. That was a lot. And I'm actually quite happy that that was a lot. It's not a lot in the way that it's like overwhelming, but a lot is in like, there's lots of little components that go into this song. it's very interesting how the song is structured, because it's almost like every single phrase of the song has its own unique genre and top line to go along with it. And all of it is different. That's very interesting. Let me. I want to.
Drop it.
That, like, this is just the first verse. But this song does contrasting styles really interestingly, in that you have a top line and an instrumental line that doesn't really match ever until you get to the chorus, especially with this first verse. It's like you have this really slow, almost, I mentioned earlier about like almost sensual, like really mature, like noir-esque, like top vocal line. But then you pair it up with this, like, it's not industrial, but it's like this really aggressive brass line. It's a super simple and isolated brass line, but it's one of those brass lines that it's like, I'm here, I'm going to make myself known type of brass line underneath it. And it's like, it's not a normal combination. You have those two types of music together, but they work with it. Let's keep going. Then they go into this glitchy pre it's the second half of the first verse. The electronic sounds in the instrumental are, I believe, they may be at a different key, they might not be, they might be just using a different part of the key that we didn't hear in the first part. But they're contrasting the really slow top line from the first half of the verse, and now they're replacing it with this really quick top line in the second half of this verse. I think that's very interesting. And then. And then this pre-chorus is almost like meeting in the middle of the first two segments of the first verse. Like, they take the more, like, almost playful, higher tone of from the second half of the verse, but they take the pacing from the first half of the vocal top line. And then on the bottom, like, instrumental line, it's more electronic-based in terms of the instruments. It's also not too in your face this time. And so while the top line is taking like a combination of the two previous parts, the instrumental line is taking like a combination of the first two parts and then taking the inverse of it. Very interesting. And then they have that 80s like drum fill lead in. And then this chorus is very reminiscent of like 80s rock, 80s pop that would have fit in on like 80s action film soundtracks. Does anybody else get that like sensation? Kind of like a maybe like a Kenny Loggins type. It's like a modernized version of a Kenny Loggins backtrack. I get that kind of feeling to it. Maybe that's where the thrill part comes in from. But from like the synth drum fill that's straight out of 1986 into this like almost like synth pop rock hybrid in this chorus here. Stylistically, there's so much going on, but I don't think that any of it's really out of place. It's like taking a drive from point A to point B. You go directly there, but instead you're going like A to B via C, D, E, and F. Does that make sense? You're taking like the long way around instead of going the direct, like typical way there. I think that's very interesting. This is very experimental in a way, and I quite enjoy listening to it. Sometimes experimental music like this, or experimental in terms of like it's not kind of like your cookie cutter pop song formula, can be hard to digest. There are certain examples. that I won't name because like that's not the whole point of this like analogy, but sometimes experimental music is above my level of musical expertise and it takes me a while to like understand it and appreciate it. Thrill by Ellis has a lot going on, but it's not too hard to digest. You just have to think about it a little bit, or at least for me, I just have to think about it a little bit, and then it's like, okay, it's clearer now. I see what they're getting at. Being musically challenged like this, I am not mad at one bit, and good stuff. Very interesting project, very interesting song. But that's it for me today. Thank you all for watching along, listening along. If you did enjoy and want to see more, channel icon is up there. You can find the back catalog stuff watched in the past. Drop a subscription if you want to keep up to date with whenever I upload new videos. And if you want to watch another video of mine right away, YouTube recommends you watch that video down there. And until next time, bye-bye.